Coming to you from his downtown Denver studio, here's the Backstage Jazz Radio Show with your host, Steve Roby.
Welcome, friends at home and friends in the studio. This is the Backstage Jazz Show, and I'm Steve Roby. My guest today is celebrated funk and jazz organist Ronnie Foster. We'll discuss his latest album, Reboot, and upcoming shows at Dazzle in downtown Denver. Welcome to Backstage Jazz, Ronnie.
Hey, Steve, thank you. Good. Thank you for having me.
It's a pleasure to have you on the show and be able to talk to such as a legend as yourself.
Oh, well, I just love what I do, man. That's all what it's about.
Well, keep doing it. Let's dive into the new album, Reboot. The album is on Blue Note, as was your debut in 1972. Can you tell me about the title's significance and how has the music evolved for you?
Well, let's talk about the title. So, you know, getting signed, you know, after 50 years to my first album is kind of crazy, first of all. And Reboot stands for kind of starting again as a solo artist, because I've been doing other things, you know, production and all that. So Reboot is like rebooting that side of me, you know, the artist side of it, and starting off, you know, where I began, which was with organ. And, you know, then, you know, I moved on and still did organ, but I did other stuff, you know, synth, all that junk. It was an amazing moment for me. Don was said, hey, we need you back at Blue Note. You deserve to be here. So that was a beautiful thing, you know. And the fact that, you know, for me, I'm 73. I'm a young 73. You know, I play basketball 5 days a week, three to four hours a day.
So, all right.
Anyway, yeah, you know, I felt that it was sincere from Blue Note's standpoint and Don's standpoint that I had value. And it wasn't a token like, oh, let's get the old guy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right.
So I'm constantly writing all the time, as I said before, you know, when I sent you the message.
Right. We'll talk about that later too. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so Reboot is, you know, starting that, starting over again as an artist. And, you know, it's been great, you know, and been really receptive to the new album.
That's great. Going back to 72 to 2023, how has the music evolved for you? And what's it feel like now?
Well, I feel that, you know, I'm always evolving musically because, you know, I said I love what I do, and, you know, I'm always, you know, searching for new things and, you know, being true to myself. You know, I speak to young artists a lot about that. I said, you know, just be you, do what you are, and be true to yourself. And, you know, if people are on board, they're on board. If they're not, they're not. But, you know, don't cater to any particular thing, you know, just be you, you know. So I've been very fortunate with that.
That's great.
I think, I mean, musically, I feel that I'm evolving all the time. I'm hopefully getting better, you know, both playing wise, vocal wise, and all that stuff. Because sometimes I go back and I listen to some of the old stuff, I go, oh, how did I get away with that? it's a constant. Music is the priority in my life. So
that's great. Back to Reboot. Who are some of the players on the record?
The main players on the record is my current trio, which is my son Chris Foster on drums, and then Michael Neal is on guitar. And Michael and I worked, you know, I was with George Benson for many, many years, and Mike came in and took Phil Upchurch's place with George. And, you know, we were in that band together. Right. And then I put some new elements into Stevie Wonder's band at one time. And Mike did that tour with us. Ah. And so, you know, Mike and I have known each other for, you know, forever. In fact, my son jokes all the time. He says, yeah, I'm kind of out on the road with my two dads, you know, because he's known, you know, Mike has known him since he was a baby. So. Yeah, so that's the nucleus of the band.
Okay.
And then I brought in, because I wanted to have different, you know, different players on a couple different things just to have a different vibe.
Sure.
You know, so Chris was on some tunes, and then I had a great drummer, Jimmy Branley. He played drums on a few tunes. Then I brought in Luis Conte and Lenny Castro, you know, because we've all been friends forever. I had brought them in all at the same time, because a lot of times you might do percussion, you know, one person and they'll overdub stuff. But I wanted to have the energy of both of them playing, you know, off of each other. Yeah, that turned out really great. Yeah, so basically that was the nucleus of the band. We did that record in 2 days.
2 days.
Yeah, we did the recording the first day. And then the second day we mixed and we were out of there.
Wow.
thankfully. Well, yeah. And, you know, and the element of that is that everything was like live, you know what I'm saying? Mm. So,
yeah.
And everybody had done their homework. So it was great. And then my engineer, Josh Conley, great engineer. I mean, he was kind of getting his mix ideas as we went down. So it was building like that. So yeah, it was great. It was only one tune I recorded after mixing, which was Jay's Dream. And that's just a solo organ piece. And that was the last thing after he mixed the last tune, that he mixed that, which was pretty easy since it was just organ.
Yeah.
And then we were out there and very proud that we were able to be one of the last sessions at Capitol Studios.
Wow.
Because they have shut the studio down because they're doing, I think it's that earthquake retrofit.
Right.
You know, yeah. And, you know, you're in LA, so, and that building's been there forever.
It sure
and it brought
has,
back yeah. memory. It brought back memories because I did a lot of string sessions on some productions I did in that studio B. And then Studio A is where we recorded Breezin' and In Flight and all that stuff, you know, with George.
Lots of great memories, I'm sure. Yeah. Let's listen to the title track, Reboot. What should our listeners know about this track?
Yeah, I mean, it's kind of like my mindset, you know, things being a little different. Mm. It's kind of funky fusion, and then chord structures, you know, like on the bridge and stuff are a little different. Yeah, and that feel that kind of thing. It's just a cool thing, and I was so proud of my son because this was his first professional recording session, you know, like for a record.
Good. And,
yeah, he killed it. So, yeah, I'm very proud of him.
Let's play it now. This is Reboot by Ronnie Foster here on Backstage Jazz. Thank you. listening to Backstage Jazz, and our guest today is Ronnie Foster. Hey, Ronnie, on the liner notes to the album, you pay homage to your special friend, Dr. Lonnie Smith. Can you talk about him a little?
First of all, we're Buffalo homies. We're both from Buffalo, New York. You know, Lonnie was like an early mentor. Yeah, it's kind of emotional for me.
So, anyway,
you know, we've always been, you know, close, and, you know, he played with George. In fact, when I met George, he was playing in George's band, the early cookbook sessions with Benson. And then, because I met George when I was 14, and Jimmy Smith introduced me to George, by the way, at 14. Wow. And that was kind of funny. And then George and I kind of started hanging out. And then Lonnie went out on his own. And when I was 15, I started playing with George on the weekends and did that for a while. I mean, getting back to Lonnie, very, you know, one of the most creative organists ever to play the instrument. And just a beautiful guy, funny guy, but he's a beautiful guy. When he got sick, he had a stroke. You know, I started talking to him like every 2 weeks until he passed. You know, we would talk and just laugh, and I play some stuff for him, you know, and all that stuff. So, yeah, it's just, you know, emotional thing, because that's you know, part of my foundation. You know, another homie. You know, and we end up, you know, being on the same label and all this stuff. So, he's just a beautiful, you know, beautiful brother, and we were always friends. And
that's a nice tribute to him. Yeah, let's get back to the album Reboot. I'm going to play Stevie Wonder's classic, Isn't She Lovely? Can you discuss this one? And what was it like working with Stevie on the songs in The Key of Life?
It was great. Stevie and I are very close friends. And, you know, we have a long history with doing a lot of crazy things and all that stuff. And we're born a day apart in the same year. And I always give him a hard time telling him that he needs to respect his elders, because I was born a day before. So we go, and we're both Taurus, so we're, you know, we're crazy. So I was around when his daughter Aisha was born, and if you go back on a lot of my albums, I always had a Stevie tune, and it became the same thing. I said, oh, you know, I gotta find a tune, and so I had that little version of it. You know, we changed the chord structure a little bit, you know, and did it my way, because I always joke with Steve, say, oh, those aren't the right chords. I say, hey, this is my arrangement. You did it your way. You know, I mean, we tease each other like that.
But that's great.
Yeah, no, it was, you know, it was kind of like a, I don't know if it was a conscious decision, but it became kind of like a thing on my albums. You know, I did, because I remember, like, what was it? Like a Child, I did Tuesday Heartbreak. Oh,
what a great song.
Then on, what was the other one? Superwoman, I did Golden Lady. You know, it just became like a little, you know, tradition. And Steve is, you know, is a big influence on me musically, especially vocally, because our timbres are very similar. Because people say, oh, you sound like Steve. I said, no, I do not sound like, and I do not sing like Steve. I said, the color of our voices are similar. You know, Donnie had that. George had that kind of airy thing. Yeah, he was a big influence, you know, the stuff that he was doing early on. You know, really, really unique. But Songs in the Key of Life was, it was great. That tune is really difficult. It was at the time, because it kept modulating at the end, you know. But it was fun. And, you know, Steve is very particular about what he wants, and, you know, that's what you got to do. So,
okay. Well, let's play it now. This is Ronnie Foster doing Stevie Wonder's Isn't She Lovely here on Backstage Jazz. Thank you. listening to Backstage Jazz, and our very special guest today is Ronnie Foster. Ronnie, in back and forth in our pre-communications to this interview, you were telling me you are constantly writing. What new projects are you working on?
Well, I can't tell you, but there's okay. another project. You know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, I'm writing for something. Yeah. Okay. That's all I could say.
We'll stay tuned for that. Okay. Well,
yeah, you'll stay tuned.
A journalist has got to ask.
Yeah, no, I understand. I don't know if you know this, but I had Stevie play drums on two of my albums. It was Delight, that was on Sony or Columbia in the day, then on Love Satellite. So, you know, he's a great drummer, obviously.
Yeah, unappreciated. I think I've heard him on a couple of things. Yeah. It's like, well, Stevie can play.
Oh, yeah.
In fact, he does a bit of drumming on a Jimi Hendrix tune.
Right.
Yeah. The Lost Archives.
Yeah, no, he's a genius.
Yeah.
And I don't use that lightly, so.
Well, let's talk about your upcoming shows at Dazzle. Who's going to join you on stage, and what can fans out there look forward to?
Okay, well, it's going to be the trio. You know, I'm very particular about, you know, when you build chemistry with, you know, other players, when we have a special chemistry, and the fact that I'm free to go wherever I'm feeling, and they will be there with me, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And like I said, this is the main nucleus of the Reboot album, with my son Chris and Michael and Neo, as I mentioned before. We kind of play many different directions, so it's always a surprise, I think, for people, because you're going to hear, you know, traditional organ trio stuff. And then you're going to hear some stuff that's maybe a little different for organ, you know what I'm saying? I think for me, as an artist and from an audience perspective, you know, there are times when you go see a band or whatever, and I'm not, you know, dissing them or anything like that, but they're just kind of one thing, and we're multiple different things. And I think that keeps the audience more engaged, you know, because it isn't the same thing constantly throughout the show. Yeah, that's what we'll be doing. We'll be playing some of the old stuff, and, you know, obviously we have to do Mystic Brew, you know, which has been sampled by, by Tribe and all that. Yeah, so we have fun. You know, the audience, there'll be, I won't say what it is, but the audience will be involved in the show. Yeah.
Sounds good,
Have a lot of fun, and we play... You know, we're emotionally based, and we play from the heart constantly with a lot of energy and passion. In fact, it's a lot of energy, you know. Yeah. Are you coming?
Oh, of course. I couldn't miss it.
Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay. Good.
I think you'll like Dazzle, too. They've moved to a new location in the Performing Arts Center.
Right.
So it's the sound. Yeah. I went over with them, and the sound is just perfect. And it's a comfortable club. Right. It feels like a jazz club. They got good food there. I think you'll really enjoy it, as do our listeners. Yeah.
Yeah. Nick was telling me, because he reached out to me earlier in the year and, you know, said, hey, you know, we want to bring you here. He said, but we're going to be moving and, you know, we want to bring you to the new place. So I was excited to check it out, because, you know, I know about, I had never played the old version, but, you know, a lot of friends have played there, so I'm really, really excited about it. You know, it's kind of the end of the year now, so we're cooling down. We only have a few more dates, and then, you know, like I said, I'm writing and we're really excited about that, and you know, three shows over two nights. So
yeah. Before I let you go, where's the best place I can send our listeners to go check out your music and your tour schedule?
Well, I mean, my music is on all music media platforms, you know, streaming and all that stuff like that. And like I said, there's only, I think we have one more date, and that's locally here in Vegas. And I think that's going to be our last date for the year, because we've done pretty much what we're going to do, obviously, this year.
Yeah.
But, and working on next year is going to be a lot stronger. We just had... You know, we're dealing with finding agents, because I haven't been out on tour for a long time, you know, finding agents, management and all that stuff. So, next year is looking really good. So Yeah, so you can find me, you know, like I said, on, you know, Apple Music,
yeah, everywhere. I'll add some links to in the show description for this podcast, so listeners can just click on them and make it real easy. Yeah, let me remind our listeners that Ronnie Foster will be appearing at Dazzle for 3 shows, starting first on Tuesday, November 14th. There's a 7 p.m. show, and on Wednesday, November 15th, you can catch Ronnie at 6:30 p.m. and there's a 9 p.m. show. Doors open 1 hour before the show, and tickets are available at dazzledenver.com. Thanks for your time today, Ronnie. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. And tell, let the audience know if they want to come up and chat after or whatever. All right. I'm very open to, you know, take pictures, whatever. All that stuff. You know, I'm very sociable.
That's great. So, are you going to bring any merch with you?
You know what? We're trying to get that here on time. That's kind of on my bad because I forgot about it. You know, I hadn't been thinking about it. But I might have some. So we'll see what happens.
That's cool.
But
Well, thank
you. There you go, man.
Thank you, Ronnie. I really appreciate your time today and enjoy your run at Dazzle.
All right. Thank you. Look forward to meeting you, man.
If you're enjoying the Backstage Jazz Show, we'd love for you to like, subscribe, and leave a review on Apple Podcasts. And now, back to the show.
The Backstage Jazz Show was recorded at Little Raven Studios in downtown Denver, and our producer was Craig Stevens. You can find Backstage Jazz wherever you listen to podcasts. Be sure to stop by our website, backstage-jazz.com, where all past and current episodes have been archived. If you'd like to be a guest on the show, you can email us at backstagejazz@fastmail.com. This is Steve Roby. Thanks for listening, and we'll see you next time on Backstage Jazz.
You've been listening to the Backstage Jazz Show. Join us next time for more great jazz and interviews with your favorite musicians.